to Sundown Close Up. Republican presidential hopeful Marco Rubio hitting the campaign trail in the Granite State around the holidays and doing it with his family. What the Republican is thankful for this season and how he plans on winning the New Hampshire primary in the new year. And close to 5 years after then, Congresswoman Gabby Giffords was shot in an event in Arizona. Her husband, astronaut Mark Kelly, remains dedicated to reforming gun laws. How New Hampshire plays into that plan. Morning, everyone, and happy holidays. Thanks for joining us. I'm Josh McKelvin. Combined, the presidential candidates have been here in New Hampshire for hundreds of days, meeting with voters, holding town halls, and going to house parties and shaking hands, everything you're supposed to do. But there's also something about running for the highest office in the land around the holidays, especially when you have your family with you. So this past week, we sat down with Republican Marco Rubio while he was in New Hampshire just before Christmas. All right, guys. Well, welcome back to New Hampshire. Good to see you.
Thank you. Glad to be back.
So you've done a lot of events recently, one in Franklin. You're drawing big crowds. You get a lot of applause for when you're, especially at the end, you really know how to wind them up. Do you feel juiced after these kinds of things?
It is. It's great. I mean, the one thing I really enjoy is that these are people who are taking this very seriously. They're not there to hear a rally. They're there to be convinced. And they're taking their decision very seriously. As I said earlier, I love when I hear we've narrowed it down to five people. It tells you how seriously they're taking it. But this is our chance here down the stretch to really convince people that I'm the right choice. And so I really enjoyed doing that. We're going to keep doing more of it.
So, Jeanette, what's all this like for you and the four kids?
It's great. I enjoy being able to come here and meet the people. I mean, we enjoy it very much. We're proud of Marco. We believe in him, and the kids get to come and also experience this. So we're having a great time.
Yeah, can you tell when he's had a day that he wouldn't consider his best day, or is he pretty much consistent with?
No, he's consistent. Yeah. He's consistent.
Consistently upset, I guess.
No, consistently
happy. I really enjoy this. This is a lot of fun.
And this is the best time. This is the best part. Honestly, for me, I love it.
It is. Me too. We get to meet. She actually told the other day, maybe we should move to New Hampshire. She really likes it up
really?
Here. Yeah.
South
I think
Florida,
it's beautiful. I mean, I love South Florida. But I love our weather, but it's just beautiful. I mean, like I was telling some of the people when we were talking, I mean, just a postcard. I love it.
Well, don't be fooled. It's not normally 70 degrees in December.
Not the weather part, but like the homes and
no,
the history. And
yes,
we don't have that in Florida. And so it's such a new, I mean, South Florida really has only been around 100 years.
Yeah, no kidding.
So just the history and all that. And for our kids to see something so different, they really have enjoyed it. And the people are so nice. I mean,
they're
we
great.
Just love that.
So for Christmas, you guys are going home. And did I hear that you roast a pig?
Well, traditionally, I roast a pig. We have this big roaster box. They call it the Chinese box, gajachina in Spanish. And it's made of plywood. And we usually do that. This year I'm a little tired and busy, so we're just going to probably buy it from someone that's already made it. But that generally we have a roast pig on Christmas Eve, which is the Latin tradition.
Yeah.
We also do a turkey.
Yeah, she doesn't eat pork. She doesn't eat the pig,
so we
make a turkey as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
but it's fried, I hope.
Oh, you see, you fry the turkey.
No,
she doesn't want to fry. It's not supposed to be healthy. It's Christmas, you know. Whatever.
Sure. The gravy and the mashed potatoes, everything. So I know that you guys got engaged on top of the Empire State Building, right? Did you ever envision back when he asked you to marry him that you'd be spending the holidays here in New Hampshire on the cusp of the New Hampshire primary?
No.
I'm not sure she would have signed up at that back then anyway. But I don't know. I never talked about that.
No, we never really talked about that. I mean, we were in the moment of whatever we were doing at that, you know, at that time. So I think we were just, you know, thinking about what we were doing at that time, plus then our family, you know, what we would do. I mean, I think
I had just graduated law school.
Yeah.
So we were really worried about how are you going to pay those loans you have? Over $100,000 I had of student loans. So.
Sure. A lot of people feeling that. So you guys have four kids, and, you know, politics isn't beanbag, they like to say. So what do you say to the kids when they come and say, oh, dad's, you know, talking about dad on TV again, or, you know, giving them a hard time?
No, I mean, they don't, I mean, they're doing their work, their homework. I mean, my second daughter, Daniela, she's very engaged in what's going on. But Marco has been involved in public service since they've been born. So they understand how this process works. We've talked to them about it, and they get it. I mean, they're proud of their dad, and they know the good that comes along with politics, but they also know the other side to that.
So. Yeah, I've been surprised at how well they've handled some of that.
Yeah.
And Daniela in particular follows it. She reads all the stuff online about the news and all that, and sometimes she just reports it to me as a matter of fact, not as she's distressed about it. So, like, I mean, I think a lot of they take their cues from their parents. If they see us upset about it, it might upset them. We just realize this is part of the process, an unfortunate part of it sometimes when people say things that aren't nice or fair, but It's worth doing to, for the future of this country, which I think is as much about them as it is about anything else for me.
Sure, definitely. I've gotten to know you a little bit over the last few months, and you've said it a couple of times that things happen over your life, kind of happen fast for you. Do you guys ever have that wow moment, though, when you have a packed hall in Franklin, New Hampshire, or Berlin, or something like that, and people are out there coming out at 8:30 in the morning to have a pancake with you and listen to you talk to you, kind of look at each other and
yeah.
say...
Well, I do, and I think Jeanette does, too, as well. It's amazing to me that people come here at 8:30 in the morning to hear me speak. You know, that they're in the middle of the holidays, tomorrow's Christmas Eve, and they took time out to hear us. So, yeah, that's very honor. It's very humbling.
It's important for them.
It tells you how seriously yeah. they're taking it. And so it only puts more of an emphasis on the fact that I need to work even harder, because this is not about me. It's not about us. It's not about our future. It's about their future, about America's future, about my children's future. So absolutely, especially when people say, we believe in you, we're supporting you. You know that you are now carrying their hopes and dreams as well in this process, that you're working for them, not just for you. Even when you're tired, even when you sometimes complain about the way things might be going because it's a long day or tomorrow's another long day, you realize it's not about you, it's about us as a country.
Sure. Talking about hopes and dreams, obviously you know you're married to a Dolphins fan.
So. No, I
wouldn't
know.
I mean, obviously football, you know, he's played it, he yeah. watches it. Is that when he really gets to relax a little bit and vent maybe during the...
Well, I mean, he calls it relaxing. I don't understand when you're screaming at the, you know, in front of the TV.
Yeah, it's not very relaxing when you're a Dolphin fan.
Yeah.
But these days...
he does. He enjoys that. I mean, that is his time off. And spending with the time with the kids and us, I mean, that's a good time for him.
Yeah, and your kids stay, I mean, they're all in sports. They all have events or anything like that. They're not missing much other than perhaps dad during the week.
Well, yes, they're very, I mean, they have school, they have their homework, they have their activities. I mean, they do miss their dad. I mean, Anthony waits every moment that he can to, you know, that Marco calls in to speak to them. I mean, but they're very busy.
Yeah. Do you get home as much as you can to catch the games and stuff?
Well, throughout this campaign, I've tried not to work Sundays. I mean, my theory is always, my belief's always been, if God could create the universe in 6 days, I can run for president in 6 days. Obviously, now as we get closer to the end, Sundays are travel days, and you're going to have to do a few things here and there. But we've been gone. I mean, I've been gone a lot, and obviously, you know, sometimes they miss things you want to be a part of. But again, what goes back is we're in this together as a family, and we, when the extent possible, try to do as many things together as we can. So coming here to New Hampshire this week was a big part of that for us. And I think, despite the schedule, they really enjoyed the retail stops. They got to go to the world's longest candy counter, and they got to see a lot of great things. And we look forward to bringing them back.
They're waiting to see snow.
Yeah, they were excited to see it. It didn't work out, but we'll be back. They've seen snow before, and I promise them there'll be snow here soon.
So you're stopping and seeing the surroundings and catching.
Oh, absolutely. And it's part of understanding where you are. I mean, one thing is to go, and it's important to have town halls and answer people's questions, but another is to go into the communities where you see what people have built with their own hands, whether it's a gun shop or a candy store or a small diner where the community gets together. Interacting with people where they are in their lives is where you really pick up a sense of what's happening in the country, and really helps you to sharpen your message about what we should be focused on in this election.
And I do have to ask you, because I'm asking all the candidates this, but you've gone through the New Hampshire primary process. I think we have less than 50 days. I haven't counted them up, but it's getting close.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people that are critical of our place in this process. I think that it's not diverse enough, or it's too small, not populated enough. Do you think it is good for the selection process? Has it made you a better candidate?
Yeah, I think it's good for America that our president, the most powerful political leader on the planet, has to begin that journey by campaigning in places like Iowa and New Hampshire. It means you start out in a rent-a-car driving to meet with 50 people at a time, answering questions from real people. You're not going to get that in a bigger state. Now, when I was in Florida, I always believed Florida should play a greater role, not in front of New Hampshire, but soon thereafter. I think that's important, too. But this early process where you have a place that's now done this for a long time, that has built in kind of an infrastructure for this sort of thing, where the highest office in the land has to start out running for basically the equivalent of a county commission somewhere, I think it's good for the process. It forces you not just to do commercials, but to answer real questions from real people, and in the process become more in tune and in touch with what's happening in our country.
And Jeanette, you obviously know the senator better than anybody. Have you watched him become a better candidate by going through this process too? I mean, obviously you spend a lot of time in the Senate.
Absolutely. The more you get to hear what the people are saying and what's important to them, and what he can try to do to make that difference, I see how he has developed and how he has changed. And even he wants to be that better candidate. He wants to be, he wants to do what he needs to do to change his country.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I noticed one thing, and we're just about out of time. You would have the ability to, one, pardon a turkey on Thanksgiving now, yeah, if you make it to the White House. And maybe you could start a new tradition by pardoning a pig at Christmas.
That would be such a good idea. No one's ever proposed that before. We'll have to do that the night before as well.
All right. Happy holidays, guys.
Happy holidays. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.